This is Robert Kraft, and I'm coming to you live on SNN Live, and we are at the Precious Metal Summit 2019 in Beaver Creek, Colorado. With me right now is Dr. Peter Megaw from MAG Silver Corp. It's a publicly traded company. The symbol is MAG on both the TSX and the NYSE American. Dr. Megaw, welcome to SNN Live.
Robert, pleasure to be here with you.
It's a pleasure to have you. So for our audience, I'll start off with an overview of the company, and then we'll go from there.
Okay. Well, MAG Silver has celebrated 16 years as a publicly listed company. We are developing the world's largest high-grade silver deposit in Mexico with our partners, Fresnillo Plc.
So let's get a history of the company. As you said, it's 16 years now a public company. Tell me, when did the company officially start, and how did you develop to where you're currently at today?
Well, we're very fortunate in that we went public in April of 2003, but we built the company on more than 15 years worth of exploration work that my Mexican partners and I had done to identify high quality projects focused on high grade district scale. And so we actually had, on the Juanicipio project, which is our flagship property, we had spent probably $2 million of Sunshine Mining Company's money. Sunshine disappeared in 2001, and the property reverted to the Mexican owner. We pulled it out, put it up, changed the names on the drill permits, and basically picked up where we had left off with Sunshine. So we were very fortunate in that we hit and proved our drilling concept, or proved our geologic concept with our very first hole. Fresnillo people came to us. We formed a joint venture. On the 16th hole, we hit the big vein, which is the Valdecañas vein that we're developing. And that did a lot of very good things for us. I mean, first of all, we were one of the first companies out of the chute in the early 2000s precious metals upswing. And our share price responded very favorably to our being successful with our exploration. So it allowed us to finance at progressively higher levels. So even though we've been in business for 16 years and we're building a major mine, we only have 86 million shares outstanding with about a $1.5 billion Canadian market cap.
So my next question is, what about this project would you say is unique when compared to some of your peers out there?
Well, what sets us apart is the grade that we have and the size of the deposit that we found. Now, we focused from the beginning on high grade and large size. We probably didn't dream we would find something quite as big and as high grade as we did, but the Bonanza Zone, which is the upper part of the vein, averages better than 6 meters wide, has a grade of about 600 grams silver, so just under 20 ounces per ton, plus 2 grams of gold, plus 5% combined lead and zinc. So it's the size, the grade, the lateral continuity, the fact that we're building it with Fresnillo PLC, the world's largest primary silver producer. They've built the same mine next door 3 times in the last 15 years. So this really is lather, rinse, repeat for them. Which takes a lot of the development risk out. The transition from being an exploration company to a development or producing company is a very difficult path, and they're taking care of that for us.
And what's your background? I mean, how'd you come into all this?
I'm an exploration geologist. I've worked in Mexico since the late 70s. Was fortunate enough to be involved in a couple of discoveries where we were able to demonstrate that the Spaniards didn't get it all, that you could go into a historic, significant district and still make a major discovery by recognizing the features that are associated with the upper parts of these systems as opposed to what people had historically, which was to find the veins sticking up out of the ground. So that's what we focused on, and in this particular case, we were extremely successful.
And then, Dr. Megaw, from what you can tell me, what are some of the company's value catalysts now moving for the rest of the year into 2020?
Well, right now, we're in what some people call the valley of death in terms of the Lassonde curve. We've been building the mine for the last 3 years. We are looking, our partners are guiding that we will be in production, have the plant started up by fourth quarter 2020. So essentially we're moving towards that incrementally. We expect to have a construction groundbreaking announcement and ceremony in the not terribly distant future. We have 5 drills turning on the property, so we could have another discovery this vein that we're working on. We call it a vein, but it's really a series of intersecting veins. There's six separate veins that combine to form this. Several of those are not even incorporated in the resource on which the mining plan is being built. We don't need that because the grade is so high. So exploration results, development go forward, and you know, just the fact that silver, if silver continues to move, will do very well. It's worth pointing out that our all-in sustaining cost, life of mine to produce an ounce of silver, is about $5.25, and that includes taxes, which is not normally included in an AISC calculation. If silver were to go to $8 an ounce, which I think is highly unlikely, we still have a 15% after-tax IRR. So that's, you know, if you want to talk about numbers, that's the sort of thing that sets us apart. The economics of this project are so good. We're looking at a 19-year mine life based on the resources that we have now, but that resource calculation was done 2 years ago, and we've done a lot of drilling since then. So this is a big long-term mine.
Speaking of that, you brought a prop.
I did. I was on the property last Thursday, and we have our first complete cross cut through the vein. It's important to understand that the top of this vein is 350 meters below the surface. So we've had to drive 3.5 kilometers of ramp down to the top of it, another 3.5 kilometers of ramp back to the top. We've drifted into the footwall. We're starting to develop the production ramps in the footwall of the vein and the initial cuts into the vein, which ultimately will be from which we extract the mineralized rock. And so this is an example of what we see in the first full cut through the vein. This is a 5.5 meter wide vein with about 1.5 meters of wall rock. We call it a horse, and then another 1.5 meters of high grade mineralization. So all the gray that you see in this rock is silver sulfide. This thing probably runs close to 10 kilograms silver per ton, so about 300 ounces. Let's be conservative and call it 250, plus probably 4 or 5 grams of gold.
And Dr. McGall, where can our audience go and find more information about MAG Silver?
www.magsilver.com is the corporate website where we have the presentation that we'll be giving here tomorrow and a lot of other information about the company. And of course, people can go to your website and see this interview and see whatever the follow-up materials are that are on your website.
My name is Robert Kraft, and I'm coming to you live on SNN Live. We're at the Precious Metal Summit 2019 in Beaver Creek, Colorado. With me again has been Dr. Peter McGaw from MAG Silver Corp, publicly traded company. The symbol is MAG, and that's both on the TSX and the NYSE American. Dr. McGaw, it was a pleasure. Thank you for joining me.
Pleasure, Robert. Look forward to doing it again.